Brother Chandan, you need to unmute yourself.
My apologies. Om Shri Sai Ram. My humble pranams and the divine lotus feet of Bhagwan Shri Satya Sai Baba. Invoking his presence amongst all of us today, we begin today's session. Good evening, everyone, and welcome on this joyful New Year day. It is my pleasure and privilege to introduce our honorable guest and speaker this evening, Sri M. K. Sridhar. Sri Sridhar is going to talk about New Education Policy 2020. All of us who have joined today live by our commitment to Vidya and our pledge to make it accessible to all. Our speaker today is one such eminent personality who has lived his life for the same cause. He is the President, Center for Education and Social Studies, Member, University Grant Commission, Member, National Steering Committee, NEP-NCF. He is also the President of Yuvaka Sangh, EC Member of the Central University of Kerala and NAAC. Earlier, Sridhar sir was a member of the Central Advisory Board of Education, Ministry of Human Resource Development, All India Board of Management Studies, AICTE, Executive Council of the Central University of Gujarat and Vice President of the Indian Red Cross Society, Karnataka. He was nominated by MHRD as a member of a committee to draft the National Education Policy under the chairmanship of Dr. K. Kasturi Rangan between 2017 and 2019. He has published numerous papers and completed many research projects. Please join me in welcoming our guest speaker today, Professor M. K. Sridhar. I take this opportunity to also welcome our expert speakers of the day, Sri V. S. Basavaraju and Mrs. Jayashree Ramesh. Ms. Karuna Sarup Munshi will begin today's proceedings with her welcome address. Ms. Munshi, an alumnus of Sri Satya Sai Institute of Higher Learning, Anandpur campus, has had an illustrious career in the field of journalism, media, as well as education. Since 2017, she is serving as the director of Sri Satya Sai Vidya Vahini program at Prashanthi Nilayam, leading an inspiring team of more than 1,500 professionals and volunteers. I now request Ms. Munshi to welcome today's gathering. Sir.
Om Shri Sai Ram and good evening, everyone. I would like to begin by bowing at the lotus feet of His Divine Worship, Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba, the founding chancellor of my alma mater, the Sri Satya Sai Institute of Higher Learning. I seek his blessings to become his worthy daughter. respected Professor M.K. Sridharji, respected Sri V.S. Basavaraju ji, and Madam Jayashri Ramesh ji. On behalf of the global Sri Satya Sai Vidya Vahini family, I welcome you very warmly to this online meet. It's really an honor to have you join us. The Sri Satya Sai Vidya Vahini is a unit of the Prashanthi Nilayam Andhra Pradesh based Sri Satya Sai Central Trust, which was established by Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba with the sole purpose to serve humanity without any distinctions. All the activities of the Sri Satya Sai Central Trust, including Sri Satya Sai Vidya Vahini, are based on Babaji's call to love all and serve all, and furthermore, to help ever and hurt never. Very simple words, but very profound and very hard to practice at all times. Baba reminded us that the hands that serve are holier than the lips that pray. Today, his mission continues to serve millions each day, everywhere, by providing clean drinking water, primary healthcare, tertiary healthcare, and education from grade 1 to post-doctoral level, and much more. Sri Satya Sai Vidya Vahini is the final frontier in the Sai education spectrum that Bhagwan started personally. Is the digital extension of the best practices of Sai education that are available universally now. As you may know, Prashanthi Nilayam, we have several schools which have been proven to be tried, tested, and true, and we follow the CBSE syllabus here, and for decades, our school here has proven to be a national topper. Top 5 schools of India include the Sri Satya Sai Higher Secondary School of Prashanthi Nilayam. But what makes us stand out is the fact that our schools are entirely residential. B, they involve no tuition, no coaching classes, no extra lessons. C, they are obviously, as with all deliverables of the Sri Satya Sai Central Trust, our schools provide education free of cost. And most importantly, we are the only schools in the entire top list of CBSE schools that are set in a rural background. Now, against this success story, Bhagwan founded Sri Satya Sai Vidya Vahini in the year 2010. And you may wonder, what does Vidya Vahini provide? We are a digital platform that empowers teachers with the sole purpose of empowering teachers with 3 deliverables: content, training, and teaching aids. And we have 2 access points. One is an internal access point and one is a national level access point. Internally, we work on an LMS, learning management system, where we serve 63 Sai rural schools and 90 government schools from Tamil Nadu from an aspirational district of Virudhunagar. And internally, they are all these 53 schools are access our content, all 3 deliverables: training, which is a blended hybrid model, teaching aids, and of course, content. They access it from our LMS. But the entire country can also access Vidya Vahini's content only, not yet the training and teaching aids, but only the content from diksha.gov.in. Now, this is because we are participating in the Honorable Prime Minister's Vidya Dan initiative to give access, free and universal access to our content to the entire country. What content do we provide, you may wonder? Grades 1 to 8, we provide content for environmental sciences, social studies, science, and mathematics. And we provide it for CBSE syllabus, Gujarat state syllabus, Karnataka state syllabus, Tamil Nadu state syllabus, Telangana state, Tamil Nadu, and Andhra Pradesh. Of course, on Diksha, currently only CBSE is parked, and the other 5 state syllabi are in the process of getting plugged and uploaded onto Diksha. We are working on the modalities. Now, CBSE alone, for grade 1 to 8, the 4 subjects that I mentioned involve 373 chapters. And we have presented these chapters in the form of 4,733 digital assets on diksha.gov.in. And with much humility, I'd like to inform you that makes us the single largest contributor of content to the Government of India's open portal, Diksha, which is the digital infrastructure for sharing of knowledge. Now, state boards will be offered very shortly, taking our count from 4,733 to about 25,000 digital assets. It's only the modalities that are being worked out. What is unique about Vidyavahini's content? It's based on what we call our unique seven asset methodology, which is a blend of best global pedagogical practices integrated with universal human values as enshrined, and Dr. Sridhar will be happy to hear, in NEP 2020. By the way, thanks, sir, for including our inputs on the need for human values-based learning and community service during school years in NEP 2020. That was a humble submission from Vidyavahini, and we saw it make its way to NEP, and we are very happy and thrilled about it. Thank you. We also provide MLPs that include scholastic learning based on Bloom's taxonomy, including activity-based learning for so that we don't leave kinesthetic and tactile learners behind. And it's integrated, as I said, with human values that are daily life relevant and make our students self-aware future citizens of Bharat and the world. The seven essays that I so proudly speak of, which are the core essence of Vidyavahini content, are the following. Inquisitive question. Day-to-day relevance, of course, the main script of the chapter, an interesting aside, activity-based learning, human values component, and questions to assess. It's a full package and is digital with PDF files, PPTs, videos, animation, totally multimedia enriched, which is customized for multi-sensory learning experience. By the way, please take note that all our multimedia offerings are original or copyright-free. We also have a very unique offering that is helping rural teachers across this country, and we call it PYF. PYF stands for Phone Your Friend. This is a bespoke English language program that we deliver over WhatsApp calls 3 times a week, each time 20 minutes. 20 into 3, 1 hour of specially designed content, bespoke customized content for vernacular speakers, keeping the influence of their mother tongue in mind. And this has transformed lives across India. We have measurable outcomes to share, anecdotal evidence to point to the powerful impact of this Sri Sathya Sai Vidyavahini deliverable on teachers and youth in rural and tier 2 and tier 3 cities of India. Now, this has become such a hit that it is currently being converted and worked upon to become a mobile app. It is going to be called Sign In App, S-A-I. IN app, and this is going to be one of the best vernacular, best English language apps for vernacular speakers, which will have both the human component, because you will still be have a mentor assigned to you. It's not all machine learning, and obviously it will be absolutely free, and it offers, this program currently has 5 levels, and we start with teachers who just say na naku sigu vuchundi English vadu, and then after a year or so, depending on how intensely they engage in the program, how regular they are, we find them becoming champions in their school and emceeing all the special assemblies, because they are the ones who can converse in English with a clear accent, clear grammar, and a strong, decent vocabulary. That self-confidence absolutely transforms the courage of that teacher inside her classroom. And sir and ma'am, we are very happy to inform you that we have several government, very intense and deep engagements with the Government of India currently. With the NCERT-CIT and the Ministry of Education, our central trust, Sri Sathya Sai Central Trust, has signed 2 MOUs. One, of course, is for the Vidyadan, under which we are sharing all the content. And the second one is for inclusive education, and we'll talk about that in a bit. We also have a huge collaboration with the Niti Aayog under the Prime Minister's TAD program, the Aspirational District Program, where we, according to Niti, and I quote Niti Aayog, we are performing some outstanding work, again with much humility and offering at Baba's lotus feet, at the Aspirational District of Virudhunagar in Tamil Nadu and in Vidisha in Madhya Pradesh. We have been requested by Niti to take this work across to more districts, but we prefer to work, our focus is on quality, not quantity, and we want our work to take root. We are not a fly-by-night NGO who can go do a big road show, excite the teachers about something, and then go away, and a year later, if we go back, we want to make sure the teachers are actually have integrated all the good practices we have taught them and made it a part of their teaching practice. So that requires time and persistence and continuous effort to make sure that the teaching learning outcomes and the culture in the school and the classroom is transformed. And this transformation is well rooted into the psyche of the teachers, the administrators, and impacting the students in a very positive way, because we like to have measurable learning outcomes for all our efforts. And now, regarding our NCERT content on Diksha, I'm pleased to inform you that CIET, the technical wing of Diksha, has been sharing some data with us. We have barely finished uploading of all our content for CBSE, and we are yet to do any promotional work. But purely due to organic practices of so us showing up in maximum searches when teachers and tutors and parents and children come, we are having lakhs of plays from for our content from north to south of India, from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, from Andaman and Nicobar to West Bengal, Mizoram, Meghalaya, and all places big and small in between. Every single district of Bharat has engaged with our content within weeks of us uploading it on Diksha. And bigger cities where teachers are very smart to see a beautiful opportunity and offering. Chennai, huge consumers. Bangalore South, enormously engaged. Ernakulam in Kerala, Pune City, Delhi South, Delhi East. Absolutely, people are devouring the content and using it extensively, and nothing could make us happier. We have put it out there to serve our country, and it makes us very happy that children somewhere are getting excited to learn in a fun way, exciting way, inquisitive way, and their love for learning is increasing because of the effort that has been put based on the 7SF methodology, which I spoke to you about. Now, what is the logical extension of what we do? A natural outcome of this spiritual activism that Bhagwan Baba has called for was the understanding that service to man is truly service to God. Manav Seva alone is Madhav Seva. To us at Sri Satya Sai Vidya Vahini, inclusion means everyone. It means all, to the exclusion of no one. Remember, love all and serve all, every single child, neurotypical, differently abled or challenged, one with special needs. Inclusion to us includes the entire gamut, the full circle of influence or impact that a child's life and his uniqueness covers, apart from the child, of course. These include the parents, the siblings, caregivers, teachers, community workers, neighbors, and policymakers. We are clear on our goal: to benchmark Bharat's place in the inclusive education space multiple notches above whatever is the best available out there in the world today. India should not have to play catch up. This entire vision is so colossal in scope and scale, yet there are no superheroes in capes or with magic wands that want to walk this path amongst us. No, sir, not at all. Instead, we are all deeply and emotionally vested in Babaji's vision and inspired from within by the role model we worship in him as our personal hero. The slender being with the halo of hair who dedicated each moment of his glorious life in the service of our nation, reaching out to the most neglected millions without ever seeking any fanfare or publicity. It is our turn now, we believe, to take his legacy forward. As an alumna, a very grateful one, of his university, I have a personal stake here, an axe to grind, if you will. It's an enormous debt of gratitude that I owe my founding chancellor, Bhagwan Baba. And I declare this to you with utmost confidence that each one of my fellow volunteers, and that would be about 1,500 of us spread in all time zones in the world, we are all fired by the same fuel of gratitude and inspiration to become the best versions of ourselves by loving everyone and serving everyone, because Babaji taught us so through his personal example. And as we do so under the Sri Satya Sai insignia, which is so sacred to us, so dear to us, we want to slate, and pardon the expression, we want to slate by ensuring that our collective output sets a brand new benchmark of professional excellence infused with empathy and compassion and unconditional love, and even more importantly, with sensitivity and respect. And guess what? We're not doing it for anyone else. We are doing it for our own self-transformation, because that's what our master taught us, that seva and service of a country, patriotism or doing your duty well, has to be done only for self-actualization, for self-transformation. And that's why we are in this game today. For us, sir and ma'am, and sirs and ma'am, it's a very historic day, because in this quest, we have yourselves, Professor Sridhar Basavaraju sir and Jai Shri Ramesh ma'am joining us. And you're here to mentor us on how best to universalize access to this gift of inclusive education through digitization coming from Prashanthi Nilayam, not only for our entire country, but the world is large. Let me end by extending a warm invitation to the three of you, as well as to Professor Kasturi Rangan sir and other esteemed members of your team of do-gooders. And most importantly, in you, I see open-minded policy influencers. So I appeal to you and I extend a loving invite to you to come and visit us at Prashanthi Nilayam. Please come and see for yourself the quietus education reform that is happening here for decades, and witness how it is silently shaping millions of lives around the world. Let's consider how best this advantage can be extended to the last child in the India growth story, so that no one is left behind in the dust of our digital transformation. We seem to be in a great rush, but let's make sure we leave nobody behind. After all, Prashanthi Nilayam is only a 90-minute drive north of Bangalore International Airport. And might I add, the highway is still well paved, at least right now, fingers crossed. The continuous rains can mess up everything. So before that happens, please come. Visit us. We just might be on to something really good. We are looking forward to welcoming you in Prashanthi Nilayam soon. And whatever we want to do, we want the medium of our delivery. Let it be on a digital platform, but digital is not the medium we're looking to achieve. Love, unconditional, universal, that a little bit of me lives in a little, and a little bit of you is the same. A little bit of me lives in every child who is challenged, and every family that is dealing with it, and every teacher who doesn't know how to respect that child and give that child the opportunity that he or she deserves. With those words, I thank you for joining us and look forward to welcoming you in Prashanthi very soon. Thank you and namaste.
Thank you, Karuna ma'am. We are very blessed and we are very happy to have you with us, Professor Sridhar sir. Thanks for joining us, Basavaraju sir and Jayashri. I will quickly take you through the overview, the framework, the other statistics and the methodology Karuna ma'am has already given you a brief summary of. I will just quickly take you through a very short presentation that will give you some insight into what is the framework we follow. And you being in the steering committee of the National Curriculum Framework, sir, will be able to see how it is correlated or how it syncs with the National Curriculum Framework. So let me share my screen.
Yes, we could see your screen, Shividyaji.
Thank you. So dedicating this at the divine lotus feet of Bhagwan, Professor sir, I present this to you on behalf of all the functional leads and the team leads of Sri Sathya Sai Vidya Vahini. As Karuna ma'am had already told you, this program was launched by Bhagwan Sri Sathya Sai Baba on 23rd November 2010. We harness technology to provide holistic learning free of cost to the entire nation. And I think we are the only program in the education platform that provide modules that are integrated with human values. Human value is not a standalone moral science kind of element that is delivered. It is integrated into every offering that goes to every stakeholder within the school ecosystem. We work on a framework that has four pillars, which we call as insightful, inspiring, enjoyable, and participative. Insightful is to ignite the minds with insightful ideas. Inspiring is the human value element that gets integrated into every aspect. It has to be enjoyable. The whole teaching learning experience has to be enjoyable, not just for the students, but for the teachers, management. Everybody in the ecosystem has to enjoy the whole process and the journey. Participative, there should be participation in active learning from every student. It should cater to everybody across the learning spectrum. Now, does this happen only in the classroom? It happens across all the four domains of learning, which we call as classroom, corridor, campus, and community. Classroom is all the learning interactions. Corridor is the immersive spaces, similar to the Bala program that the Ministry of Education has. Campus is the enabling culture, and community is the outreach. Now, the main deliverables or the offerings that Vidyavahini takes as a package to offer all this through the framework is a package of content, teaching and learning aids, and training. So everything that we deliver as a package of content, teaching, learning aids is supported by orientations and trainings. Now, this is a sample framework for you, which will give you some idea about what is delivered through the framework. I will not go into the detail of it, but I would like to tell you, sir, that if you were to correlate this with what is prescribed by the National Curriculum Framework, you will be able to clearly see that there is some offering or the other which is fulfilling the requirement of NCF. And the summum bonum of these offerings as a package put together can definitely help in curriculum attainment. So like Karuna ma'am already spoke to you, we have master lesson plans supported by multimedia aids for classroom usage. We have an activity-based learning package that works as a package for the no bag day, which can happen once in a week, where the school only explores activity-based learning. And then we also have an art and craft package where there is teacher's handbook and student's workbook. We cater to different boards, not just focusing on CBSE. At present, we have ready content for these seven boards that are listed here. We are also working on West Bengal board, Maharashtra board. Our horizons are expanding. And we have about 1,500 MLPs with multimedia aids across boards. And that will totally add up to almost 23,000 digital assets. Spandana is our activity-based learning package. Sameet is our art and craft package. Spandana has about 19 activities, which is enabled by lesson plans and activity kits. Sameep has about 288 art and craft lesson plans and teaching resources. We have a foundational literacy bridge program, which we call as SOPAN. This helps in bridging the literacy gap through activity-based learning. It's a bilingual learning and it caters to all types of learners, auditory, visual, kinesthetic, and tactile. This program has been successfully launched and is working successfully with very good outcomes, recorded data-based outcomes in almost 90 schools of the Virudhunagar block in Tamil Nadu as part of the aspirational district Niti Aayog program. As part of this program, 28 master trainers have been trained and are ready to take it forward. 224 teachers have been trained fully. This program has benefited almost 5,000 plus students, and nearly 2,700 students have been assessed. This is a pre-assessment program assessment and a post-assessment kind of program. And it takes the student through various levels till they become literate from foundational aspects. Our training program is a full-fledged package. We have two aspects of training. One is training our own volunteers, because every volunteer who is ready to serve the project has to be fully trained. Plus, we have to train the users of what we deliver. So we have self-paced training programs which run through our learning management systems. We also have virtual orientations and trainings over and above the self-paced learning modules. We also conduct workshops, seminars, and meets. We used to have a number of training programs being conducted in the schools with clusters of schools in a common place and in Prashanthi Nilayam and various other common places. But due to pandemic, those have been stalled for the time being, but we've held number of training programs non-virtually also. So we not only train the Vidyavahini volunteers who need to take up various roles, the management and the school teachers are also trained. So for our volunteers, we have trained the trainers. We have master trainers who prepare trainers who have to train further. We have volunteer onboarding orientations and trainings. We have functional team trainings. That is, depending upon which team you're going to serve, if you're going to serve the content team or you're going to serve the school management team, depending upon which team you're going to train, you get further trained. And role-specific training, if you're a subject matter expert, if you're a pedagogy reviewer. So depending upon what role you're going to take, that training also happens. Plus, we have training for the school management, the teachers and various stakeholders of the school who have to use what is delivered to them in the right way. And this is all done not just as instructional training modules. We have soft skill-based trainings, competency-based training, and since everything is digitally delivered, we have technology training that is required for that particular role or for that particular offering. PYF, as Karuna ma'am told you, is one of our star programs, Phone Your Friend. This program is basically to ensure that communicative English is developed in the teachers, and the teachers feel confident to deliver and teach in English and also communicate well in English. So this program is leveled in 5 levels: elementary, basic, intermediate, upper intermediate, and advanced. The focus is on the LSRW skills. It is a well-designed exclusive curriculum. There are 3 calls made between the mentee and the mentor. The mentor calls the mentee. And each of these calls have a structured syllabus, have a structured approach, and all the trainers, all the mentors are trained, and each of these modules are run for 24 weeks, and each session is a 20-minute session, and it runs for 3 times in a week, and there is certification after assessment. And we started with 127 teachers to train 127 teachers across 16 schools from 9 states. And by February 2020, it went up to 260 beneficiaries across 38 schools in 14 states. And today we have 750 plus beneficiaries, and it is growing. And there is so much ask for the program with the mobile application called Sign In that will be available to everybody very soon. I'm sure these numbers will reach thousands and millions. Technology. We harness technology to extend all our modules to the schools. We have an exclusive content generation and a curation portal, which we called as Content Management System Portal, which is our portal in which everybody creates and reviews and structures our content. We have a mobile application and a learning management system. And of course, we will very soon, we have already launched the sign-in application for Phone Your Friend, but certain preparatory things are happening and it will be available for everybody across India very soon. For everything, we need to finally look at how it can be implemented and sustained. One thing is to create, one thing is to make quality modules, one thing is to put it on a digital platform accessible to everybody. But the other side of the coin is to ensure proper implementation and sustenance happens in schools. Otherwise, it is just information that is available to everybody. So in order to take it beyond information, in order to make it a practical solution for every school system, we have a standard operating procedure, which goes by a step-by-step milestone approach. And this is also something which is looked into and step-by-step, very structurally and comprehensively followed by the state management teams in each of our schools. So we first categorize the schools. The categorizing of the schools is not to label the schools or not to put them into categories, but to understand them better so that we can help them progress and reach from one level to the next level. And we package our offerings according to the category of the schools so that the school is able to relate to it and the school can easily implement and sustain it. It is milestone based. We have specific structured interventions. And after these interventions are delivered, there is monitoring and we help them to we help to see where are the gaps based on our monitoring. And we have continuous mentoring to help them to bridge those gaps. As of today, we serve 153 schools, and I think about 95% or more of these schools are all rural schools, typical rural schools across India. And in the other 5% are also semi-urban schools. And with this, I come to a conclusion. I conclude my presentation with Swami's quotation, which says, "True education is that which bestows on one the wealth of morality, spirituality, and character." So we believe in taking forward education across the four domains of learning with value integration. I'll now call on Saurabh to take us through what we have planned and what we have structured for the inclusive education curriculum, which is based on universal design of learning. Thank you, sir. Thank you for...
Thank you, Dr. Srividya, for that enlightening talk on framework and methodology of Sri Satya Sai Vidya Vahini program. For most of us, Dr. Srividya Sridhar is a very familiar name. Dr. Sridhar has been one core member of Vidya Vahini team. Currently, she is a member of project management team and she is guiding the initiative of inclusive education project for Sri Satya Sai Vidya Vahini. I also take this opportunity to thank Ms. Munshi for that wonderful overview and Sri Satya Sai Baba's guidance on education. I quote, "Education is for life and not for living alone," end quote. I am now pleased to introduce Mr. Saurabh Saxena, an alumnus of Sri Satya Sai Institute of Higher Learning. Mr. Saurabh has dedicated his life for children with special needs. Currently, he is serving as project management team at Sri Satya Sai Vidya Vahini Inclusive Education Project. He will take us through the substance of Inclusive Education Project. Over to Mr. Saurabh Saxena. Thank you.
Thank you, Chandan. Loving pranams at the lotus feet of Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba. Thank you, Karnaji, Sri Vidyaji, for setting the context for today's session. Today, we are truly blessed to have none other than Sri M.K. Sridhar himself, who was a member of NEP 2020 drafting committee. A very, very warm welcome to you once again, sir. I'll try to keep my presentation as short as possible, as everyone gathered here from around the globe is eagerly waiting to hear the golden words of advice from you. I also extend a very warm welcome to Sri Basavaraju sir and Madam Jayashri Ramesh as well. The tagline for this inclusive education project, expansive feeling, inclusive thinking, and intuitive vision, was given by Sri Satya Sai Baba himself. Expansive feeling is to be able to feel everyone's happiness and pain, being aware, being understanding, and being accepting of diversity as all are limbs of God. Inclusive thinking is universal approach to everything, no one left behind, using skills and efforts to promote welfare and prosperity of the society. And intuitive vision is intuitively doing the right thing at the right time, looking beyond disabilities, focusing on possibilities, and focusing on capabilities and expanding possibilities. Now, the sixth All India Education Survey done by NCERT in 1998 states, at least 10% of all students are likely to have special education needs. That means 1 in 10 will have special education needs. The survey further states, at least 15% of all students will become parents of children with disabilities. This means 1 in 7 will become a parent of a child with disabilities. Since this survey was done 27 years ago, this must already be true. This would further mean that all of us have a child with disabilities in our own extended families or neighborhoods. A much recent survey that was done in 2019 with specific reference to children with disabilities states, 3/4 of the children with disabilities at the age of 5 years and 1/4 between 5 and 19 years do not go to any educational institution. And the number of children enrolled in school drops significantly with each successive level of schooling. So basically 3/4 of the children with disabilities are filtered out of the system right at the very beginning. And 1/4 of those who are left in the system are subsequently filtered out with each successive level of schooling. If one goes through the RPWD Act 2016, it lists 21 disabilities, and that's not all. There are many more. Various estimates state that there are anywhere between 1 to 1.5 billion people with disabilities around the world. So how will we approach the project with this kind of diversity? The challenges of a person with any kind of disability, when analyzed closely, can be summarized as under: mobility, sensory, communication, motivational, social emotional, and cognitive and life skills. The content that we are making would help deal with these challenges and make learning gainful, accessible, possible, and enjoyable. In fact, sir, we are delighted to share that this maps very well with the vision of NEP 2020 that specifically mentions about ECCE, that is Early Childhood Care and Education. The overall aim of ECCE will be to attain optimal outcomes in the domains of physical and motor development, cognitive development, socio-emotional ethical development, cultural development, and development of communication. Let me now just give a brief overview of what we are planning to do in this project. We would provide digital access to scholastic and non-scholastic content. If children cannot learn the way they are currently taught, we will provide the content in a way so that the teachers can teach the way the children can learn. Content will be provided to help children become functionally independent with skills that are necessary for daily living and having a good quality of life. Our content will help to intentionally plan for success of all students. It will help to take inclusion beyond just physical inclusion. We hope that it will enable social, cognitive, and emotional inclusion as well. Creating a school that is truly inclusive first starts in our minds. It requires a shift in the culture and use of specific strategies by all stakeholders. Our project would suggest policies, practices, SOPs, teaching models, learning material, infrastructure changes, and so on. Digital content would be provided for developing pre-vocational and vocational skills. Sensitization sessions, seminars, workshops, etc. for stakeholders. Stakeholders will be empowered with tools and techniques and training. And the stakeholders would include children with special needs, teachers, management, administration, peers, parents of peers, and many, many more. And last but not the least, God willing, This will be an attempt. Sensitization beyond campus boundaries would be an attempt to make our public places more inclusive. These would include, but not be limited to, bus stations, railway stations, airports, places of worships, wedding halls, and so on. For the classroom education, we plan to use the methodology of universal design of learning, which basically focuses on multiple ways of presenting to students, multiple ways of allowing students to interact and respond, and multiple ways of engaging students. Sridhar sir, your keynote address at Central University of Karnataka was so inspiring for volunteers like all of us who have gathered here today. For the benefit of the audience today, I would like to share some of those words of inspiration that focuses on doing rather than talking alone. I recall you had said, much is talked about what is there in NEP 2020. The question, however, is how we implement it. We need not discuss what has to happen in the country or state or in other universities. We need to focus on what has to happen in our institution as per the policy. It means that we, as an institution, need to devise models of implementation of specific aspects of NEP 2020, which could be adopted by other institutions. General talk on implementation without the development of specific models wouldn't be of much use. Sir, we are indeed working on developing the models as well as the content that could be used by the institutions as well as caregivers. We hope that our models will help in changing the mindsets of management and reorient them. We hope our model and content will help various stakeholders overcome the challenges they face in implementation. Our project would work on policies, processes, pedagogy, procedures, and practices. Typical policy frameworks, compliance with regulatory requirements, compliance with CBSE requirements, identification of children with special needs, roles and responsibilities, admission policies, and so on. Processes like identification of special education needs, supporting the child in the school, reviewing the support, creating accountability at every level, creating inclusion champions, quality circles, and so on. Pedagogy, through our digital content, three broad kind of teaching needs would be addressed in the classrooms. Needs common to all learners, needs specific to a group of learners, and needs unique to individual learners. Procedures like admission procedures, collaboration between general education and special education teachers, and so on. Practices like peer buddy, peer tutoring, circle of friends, eating companion, collaborative learning, multisensory learning, and so on. Our proposal not only aims at delivering the scholastic content to the digital medium, it aims at helping address the 5 P's with the help of the 6th and the 7th P. And the 6th P is provision, that is making available the resources, and the 7th P is provision, which is proactive vision. The outcome expected is an enlightened parent, an empowered teacher, and most importantly, a happy child. Typical educational framework focuses only on cognitive excellence. Our framework focuses on the whole person approach. This is the approach we intend to bring into the framework that we have created for this project. So emotional skills, motor skills, communication skills, daily living skills, human values and behavioral skills, social skills, cognitive skills, pre-vocational skills, and vocational skills would be catered to. As you can see, cognitive skills sit on top and are gained and work well only when the other foundational skills have been gained. A few words about making of the prototypes. The factors that we keep in mind while making the scholastic content are principles of UDL, inclusive learning environment, soft and hard, multisensory learning. This helps in activating parts of the brain simultaneously, thus enhancing learning process. Learning styles. Basically, most people have a preferred way to learn, and the content will help the teachers to tap the same. Multiple intelligences. Traditionally, it is believed that a person's intelligence is fixed at birth, but that's not true. Everyone possesses a mixed bag of intelligence and innate talents, and with different ways of learning, retaining information, and understanding the world. And our digital content will take into account this very important factor. And last but not the least, content will be enabled with Indian Sign Language. These are the project verticals, an overview of different areas that we would be working on under the Inclusive Education Project: environmental studies, mathematics, arts and craft, foundational literacy, foundational numeracy, computer skills, training, ADL, emotional and behavioral skills, peer systems, pre-vocational skills, vocational skills, sports and games, bulletin boards, assembly and special programs, policies and procedures, communication skills, infrastructure, motor skills, social and interpersonal skills, walls and corridors, yoga, music and dance, leisure skills, TLMs, social stories, and inspirational videos. And these project verticals would be supported by the volunteer onboarding team, legal and accounting team, document control team, UDL review, tech support, and project management team. This is the larger picture that we hope this project will help us achieve. Sri Satya Sai Inclusive Education Project is coming up with Sri Satya Sai Vidyavahini approach that will benefit all children, neurotypical and children with special needs as well. This would lead to happy children and reduce burden on healthcare and education, and happy parents and families, which should lead to a happy society. Sri Satya Sai Vidyavahini approach would enable inclusive education, which would be more than just physical proximity, which should lead to respect for diversity, fatherhood of God and brotherhood of man, inclusive society, because inclusive education is a foundation for equitable society. Special children and adults will be valued and provided equal opportunities in all spheres that should lead to enhanced self-esteem and self-confidence and ability to lead an independent life, and finally, improved social interaction and bonding. And all this is possible only by developing the mantra that Baba had given us way back in 1974, expansive feeling, inclusive thinking, and intuitive vision. Once when Confucius was traveling with his disciples, he heard a very intelligent boy was living in this particular village. Confucius went to see and talk to this boy, and he jokingly asked this boy, "How would you like to help me do away with all the inequalities in the world?" "But why?" asked the boy. "If you flattened the mountains, the birds would have no shelter. If you filled up deep rivers and the sea, the fish would die. If everyone had as much authority as the head of the village, no one would know where they were. The world is vast enough to cope with differences. We hope our project will help in contributing to making of the world where the differences are celebrated. Vasudeva Kutumbakam, one world, one family. And we believe universal design of learning can only be achieved through the universal design of love. Thank you for your patient hearing. And now over to Mr. Chandan. Sai Ram.
Thank you, Brother Saurabh Saxena, for that informative presentation on inclusive education project in such a concise way. The time has come for which all of us have gathered around this evening here. It is my absolute honor and privilege to request Professor M.K. Sridhar to address the gathering. Sir, all of us are eagerly waiting to hear the enlightening word of wisdom from you after this festival of lights. Over to Professor M.K. Sridhar.
Namaste to everyone here. Physically, I used to live very near to Puttaparthi. That is where I spent my childhood and student days. I visited him. I took his blessings. And he called me as Bangaru. That is the word that he used to. So I bow my head in respect to Sri Satya Sai Baba and the kind of inspiration that he has given to all of us to serve humanity with love and no hatred. Friends, brothers and sisters, it's my pleasure and privilege to be amongst you today after celebrating the Festival of Lights. See, many a time we look for physical lights, but every one of us, by that divine intervention, every one of us has a light within. And it is that light which is being celebrated today, which we give a technical name as Deepavali or Diwali or whatever. I think in the last 45, 50 minutes, Karuna Sarup Ji, Munshi Ji, Dr. Sri Vidya Sridhar, and Saurabh Saxena, all of you gave a very good account of what you are doing, not just what you are doing, but a very well thought out approach, principles, and the design. See, many a time it so happens that when we are in voluntary work, we tend to do things, it's more of activities. But if you see the logic and if you see the rational, that will be missing. It will be full of activities and activities. As a result of which, many of the voluntary activities will not create that impact. See, after all of us are doing all these things to create some impact somewhere. But they become many a time piecemeal, ad hoc, and you know, whims and fancies. As a result, we do not see much impact. Against that, I saw in three of you when you presented different facets of what you did, starting with an overview and ending with inclusive education. You know, there is a very, very clear-cut thought process and a very logic, and which is the need of the hour. I think that makes you to stand out from others. No doubt, because you are 1,500 strong volunteer corps in different time zones of the world. Maybe you are constrained to focus on digital platform, mostly on digital platform. But possibly in the days to come, is there anything beyond digital platform that we can also think? That is also one possibility, because digital platform is fine. Technology is good. But then there is something beyond technology also. That human component, that personal touch, that social interface, that feeling of real empathy that will come when we start going beyond this technology. That I leave it to you. It also depends. The second point, the second observation that I would like to make here is, in spite of being a voluntary group, it's amazing that you have put together in a such a so systematic and methodical way. Even the most of the formal systems, which have got all kinds of management, they don't plan and execute things in the way that you have done. It's amazing. It is no doubt informal and non-formal, but the impact is very high. Do you know why the impact is very high? The impact is very high because of two reasons. One is the kind of dedication with which you are doing. That dedication. You know, all of us are doing everything at the lotus feet of Sri Satya Bhai, Bhagavan Satya Sai. That kind of dedication. Added to that dedication, the entire thing is done in a very, very professional way. So therefore, impact is very much seen. That's why you could reach out to Niti Aayog, NCRT, Diksha platform, all possible things that you could reach out. The aspirational district, Virudhunagar. All these things you could do because of this. So I once again take this opportunity to, I don't know whether to congratulate you, to appreciate you, because when you are doing it as a matter of duty, it is also not very advisable on my part to appreciate you, to congratulate you, because you are doing things in so natural way. But still, I acknowledge all your efforts. After going through many of the things that you are doing, the content part, the methodology part, on different dimensions, I feel you are already addressing many components of national education policy, many of the things. In fact, I remember and recollect the kind of input that we got from your group. I remember, still remember the material that I received when we were in the process of, you know, writing this policy. And that entire material was very useful with regard to that values and things like that. We have included a lot of things in the report, but everything, all that may not be reflected in the policy, because policy is a smaller document. It's an abridged one. So there is a brevity in policy. So many things that we have said in the policy, you already started doing it. But what I see, the silver lining that is very, very important is, maybe in the days to come, especially in the field of school education in general and inclusive education in particular, if you can align all your efforts to what is happening under the aegis of national education policy, I think that will set the agenda better. You know, for example, let me start with a couple of examples. See, the process of national curriculum framework has already commenced. When the national curriculum framework has commenced, there are going to be, you know, different groups for preparing position papers, which will act as input for the national curriculum framework. 25 themes. So these themes, we can always share the details with you. Maybe if you can start organizing yourself in such a way that you start giving this kind of input to the plan that is underway, I think that will serve the purpose better. Again, let me take another example within that. There is a working group on social sciences. There is a working group on science education. And there is another group on vocational education. So your sum total of the entire work and your expertise and your experience, if you can convert it with regard to that particular area, if you can convert into inputs for the national curriculum framework, it will serve the purpose far much better. What I am only trying to put across to you is, the entire thing that you are doing, if you can put it in the format that is being done today, it will serve the purpose better. Second, let me give another example here. See, I think you know that the policy has outlined 4 stages of school education. 5+3+3+4. And the national curriculum framework, possibly this is what I am hoping the committee has to take a final call on this. But there is a consideration happening that how the national curriculum framework must be there for the first 5 years, which is called foundation stage. And then the next 3 years is called preparatory stage. Then middle stage and then secondary stage. So the total input that you are giving for the curriculum framework, can it be put in this particular fashion of 5+3+3+4? I think that will be very targeted, and many people who may know a lot of things, they will not be in a position to do so in such a way, because they may have commitment, but we do not know their professional capability to do that. That's why I said To start with, it is commitment as well as professionalism. And you have that commitment, I need not have to doubt anything. And you also have that professional competence. You will have to only put it in this particular way. Then thirdly, once you have given the lot of input for school education, there is also something called for teacher education. The National Curriculum Framework for Teacher Education is also being underway. Now, if you take the foundation stage, the curriculum framework, if it is going to be this, then the teachers who are going to become, all those who are going to become the teachers for foundation stage, what should be inputs for them? You know, it has to be linked to that teacher. If my information is right, that teacher education of that integrated teacher education program, ITEP, what we have proposed in the policy, 4-year, you know, B.Ed program, including the degree, etc. That will not be a generic degree, if my information is right. That means today, when you take a B.Ed, you can be a teacher for any class at any stage. This is now gone, and you will become, suppose if you have opted for that stage where there is foundation stage, you have opted to become a teacher for foundation stage, then that content and that curriculum framework will be different from when you opt for preparatory stage and middle stage. And definitely it will be different from the secondary stage. So the kind of teachers that you will be preparing for foundation stage, for preparatory and middle together, and then secondary stage, it will be different. There may be some common things, but there will be a lot of variation also. So if that can happen, I think that will strengthen teacher education also. So like this, your entire expertise, experience, and the entire work that you have put in all these years, if it can be converted, if it can be, you know, rather put it, if it can be developed in the format that is needed for developing national curriculum framework for school education, for early childhood care and education, as well as for teacher education, I think you will be performing a national duty. Whatever that you are going to give, it will really become a national duty. So therefore, my request to all of you is, if you can orient that a small team can be set up among you, can be set up amongst you, and you take that as a project. You know, how do we do this? And if you want, I am always available. We can always discuss. And I will also guide you how to go about, because I'll be knowing the latest developments, whom to contact and whom to give all that. See, I want to see the value of your effort, value of our experience, and value for your expertise. And much more than anything else, for your devotion and commitment. So this is what I feel. How do we leverage your work? How do we leverage your experience for serving, for performing national duty? Otherwise, we will be doing our own work. We are satisfied. We are happy. And the people to whom we are serving, they will also be happy. But you know, the impact wise, I do not know whether the impact will be up to the mark. So therefore, one submission to you, how do you contribute more in the form of impact of national education policy by aligning your entire work in this particular fashion? This is what I wanted to share with you. If you have anything, maybe a couple of minutes, I can answer any of your few questions if you have. But this is what I primarily wanted to share with you. And I did not want to go too much into again the policy, explain the policy and things like that, because you know very much and you have done a lot of work with regard to this, even much before the policy. So I never thought it is very necessary to explain all that to you. But this is what I wanted to share with you. Maybe if there is time and if you want, maybe a few more minutes we can devote for some answering couple of questions if you have any. Namaskar.
Thank you, Professor M.K. Sridhar, for those pearls of wisdom and profound as well as inspiring words on how to become more effective. Thank you very much, sir. Shri Sadasai Vidyavahini Inclusive Education Project, look forward to having your continued guidance on this very important project. I now request Ms. Munshi to express our appreciation to Professor Sridhar for taking his time out and being with us today. Over to Ms. Munshi.
Namaste, sir, once again. Really enjoyed and deeply inspired by your vision and your clarity. And on behalf of my entire team, I thank you profusely for taking the time to join us. I was taking notes as you were speaking because everything you said, our team was taken up by it, and all of us taking note of it. You made a very pertinent point, sir, about going beyond just digital connect, right? I'm ready to inform you that we actually go in, we connect with our in-person. Now, every state, like we have 63 satellite rural schools spread across India. And we also work with the 90 government schools in Virudhunagar. Everywhere we have an in-person connect. And in every state of India, for example, in Karnataka, we have a full-fledged Vidyavahini state team. We have a state name, an IT a subject matter expert, a phone your friend coordinator, under whom there's a full slew of volunteers who drive over, meet the schools and work, handhold the teachers and work in person with principals, administration, students and teachers. During the pandemic, of course, our movement was restricted, and being digital came in very handy, sir, because we were able to teach these rural teachers overnight. They had to have a quantum jump in their learning, and they had to learn how the stuff that we were teaching them, they could all children using a smartphone. But we have on the ground volunteers who physically visit these places in Virudhunagar and the local Virudhunagar, the Sai Samiti. What is special about the Satisai movement is that we have this 5 lakh strong sister organization called the Sri Satisai Seva Organization, and it is practically present in every district of India. So we have sevaks, we have volunteers, we have a huge support system available to us. Of course, we are a specialized program, so we generally look for people who might have a background in A, teaching, B, technology, C, training. And then we, because with that background, we have to orient them into Vidyavahini deliverables, and they help us on the ground. So we have volunteers across this country. Lack of manpower is not a concern. Lack of motivation is not a concern, and lack of discipline is not an issue in the Satisai organization. So we make it a point to meet them in person and do the rest. Now, all the things you said about NEP, thank you for that acknowledgement. We, on behalf of my entire team, I thank you. And I'm so happy to know that someone actually read what we sent, because sometimes you wonder, you know, you're sending stuff on an email ID and is someone paying attention? I'm glad you liked our inputs. Sir, about the 25 themes of the National Curriculum Framework. Now, that is something that is very exciting for us, because for all the themes and the 5+3+3+4 format, and the need to synchronize that format with the teacher education so that we zoom out and take an overview of the whole situation, realizing that each segment is unique, but the overarching picture has to be well meshed and synchronized, so there are no jumps and leaps and bounds in the development of a child or the unfoldment of the overall policy. Regarding that, I would once again, at the expense of sounding like a broken record, may I repeat that I would love for you to come and see the proof of concept in Prashanthi Nilayam, sir. All this is already playing out for decades now. And we do the foundational work, we do the middle school, the high school. And I told you, we don't have the culture of coaching classes and extra tuition. All this is done in a very comprehensive system where children are residentially are in a residential system, and we continue to ace. And our achievements on CBSE is only part of our success story, because for us, the emphasis is on character development. Because Baba has told us to balance academic achievement with character development. So our children do so much more, from sports and yoga to self-reliance programs to cultural stuff, Veda chanting, everything they can do. And that proof of concept, once you have a look at it, sir, in person, I think you will see that what is being discussed, there is a proof of concept happening very silently in a very quiet village. And this very idea of aligning what we have to offer within the 25 themes of NCF is something that needs to be decided at a policy level by our parent organization, the Sri Satisai Central Trust. That is why it would be wonderful if yourself and Basav Raju sir, Jayashree madam, and of course Professor Kasturi Rangan sir, all of you can just make a visit. We can set up a meeting with the members of the trust and some of our own decision makers here, and we can have a face-to-face discussion and sort it out how best, because serving the nation is what Baba has taught us. Good citizenship, responsible citizenship, and expressing our patriotism by serving society, that is the theme of the Satisai mission. So that is an area we would love to engage with and explore further upon your visit to Prashanthi Nilayam, sir. With those words, I thank you once again. You were awesome. You made our day, and we feel so honored that you took the time to engage with us, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. We now have two of our external speakers who have worked their entire life for the betterment of persons with disabilities. First, we have Sri V.S. Basavaraju, former State Commissioner for Disabilities, Government of Karnataka, and the Founder Secretary of Disability NGOs Alliance for DN. Sri Basavaraju has dedicated over 3.5 decades of his life in the service to the disability sector. I now request Sri Basavaraju sir to guide all the volunteers of Vidyavahini.
First of all, thank you. It's been a great honor to connect with all of you. And respected Professor Sridhar sir, Karuna ma'am, Saurabh, Brother Saurabh, and Sister Sri Vidya, and all others. My pranams to all of you. It has been a great journey, learning for the last few weeks for me, particularly to learn about the kind of work that has been done by Sri Satishai Vidyavahini team. And I must say that they have gone so depth in every respect. And we have a small little opportunity to do whatever that we could do from our side as our seva to this great work. To me, I think whatever we wanted to say, Professor M.K. Sridhar already said it. And I would fully agree with him that as a country, the lot of depth that we need to look into, because the disability inclusion still a very little understood by the larger system, particularly the NCERT, the Ministry of Human Resource Development and universities. So therefore, my request and urge for you is to build that foundation with them, because once if they have a kind of proper understanding, a foundation if they have better, I think it makes all of our life easy. And I'm so glad that Sri Satishai Vidyavahini team is engaged in this great work, and I have no doubt that now it will go to a whole new level, particularly the kind of volunteers, about 1,500 volunteers, and who have got the large experience, and you know, not only the professional expertise, they also have a lot of devotion to this work. So things would really go much more in a better way. And I only wish that I think we have to lay a good foundation, because the only foundation that can really change the whole thing. I mean, I'm sure as we start really work, we all can put in our time and energy to see how we can support each other and make sure that whatever we wanted will be done. And most importantly, I look at the kind of requirement today is to bring certain level of standards, because disability work in the country is seen as mostly the work of a voluntary organizations, the work of a parents, and still as a system, as an government, as an organization, still to own this. And I'm sure with NEP, this will happen. And in next 5 to 10 years, we see at least all our children with special needs will be included in every respect, in every aspects. And we're only here to see how we can join hands with all of you to the effort that you people are doing, so that the work will really go smoothly. And the particularly, my heart goes to the parents, because very little effort, very little support are provided to the parents groups. So therefore, my urge and request for all of you is also to sort of develop a kind of a module that will empower, enable, and support the parent groups, so that they can also actively engage in the process of improving inclusive education across the country. Because I see the engagement of the parents is very, very critical and very important in order to get everybody involved and everybody to pay the requisite time and an effort in enabling the quality support and quality education, inclusive education for children with all categories of disability. Of course, like earlier Mr. Saurabh said, one of the major concerns for all of us is the dropout rate is very, very high in the country. So I'm sure with some of the work, the fundamental work, what Satishai Vidyavahini is doing will definitely bring a huge change, a huge shift in the days to come. My request for all of the volunteers and to continue to give us the kind of rich professional experience and expertise you people have, so that we can blend with our own learning, our own understanding of what happens at the field level, and we can continue to evolve and develop, so that in the days to come, we will see in our own eyes how things can change for people with disability, not only in the area of education, in the overall quality of life, and the way they look at the society, look at them as the people with disability as more as a resource a contributors, a great citizens, and who can contribute in every way. And my pranams to all of you. Thank you so much for this opportunity. And this is only my opportunity to work with all of you to see how we could take this vision forward and do our bit so that, like Professor Sridhar said, it's a national duty. We all of us have to do this, and we are very happy to contribute in whatever way that we can. Thank you so much. Thank you for this opportunity. Pranams.
Thank you, sir, for those motivating words. Your life example is inspiration for all of us. We have a saying, Asha Amar Hai, which translates that hope is immortal. Today, we have someone who has given hope to so many families by her tireless work in the field of special education and especially in autism spectrum. I now have the pleasure in inviting Mr. Jayashree Ramesh, Director and Founding Member of ASHA, Academy for Severe Handicaps and Autism, to share her thoughts with all of us.
Good evening, everyone. Karuna ma'am, thank you so much, Dr. Srividya, for inviting me here. And it's such an honor, just like Basraj sir was saying. Sridhar sir, namaskara. We had met earlier when we were doing the training in Kannada for teachers from across the state of Karnataka very recently. I'm very excited when I first looked at NEP, the first draft came out and there were discussions. You know, it was really very striking that even children with special needs were being considered. Though NEP did not detail how inclusion was going to happen, but we saw that there was a light somewhere. And this I felt very strongly for two reasons. One is, you know, coming from the disability sector and working in a framework of special schools, it's a very crazy kind of a situation because we don't really belong to any particular department. And I keep saying this, you know, very openly, nobody is checking on the quality of our work. Nobody is telling us what we are supposed to do, what is the curriculum framework, and whether children are learning or not learning, you know, and even in terms of what is the kind of fee that you're charging and why is it that you're charging, you know, what you're charging. None of these are mandatory requirements from an administrator's perspective. So it gives me tremendous power to do whatever it is that I feel like doing. I may have an IEP in place, I may have trained teachers in place, or I may not have. I may have 8 or 10 children with disability and one teacher, or I may choose to have 2 children and one teacher, you know, as a ratio. It is up to me. Because nowhere in the law it is making mandatory that I'm supposed to follow certain things. So when NEP came up, you know, it gives you a feeling that even children with special needs, even in the field of special education, is ultimately going to come under a framework. So that was very thrilling. And listening to Saurabh ji, I feel that It's a good time to be a student again. If I could go to a school that would provide that environment for me, where my teachers understand me, I am not, you know, worried where my parent is going to get called and, you know, I will be put in a corner or I'm being dragged to a principal's office, always with a complaint that this child is not sitting in a place or, you know, is always disturbing somebody. I mean, I would enjoy school much more than what is happening today. Because I look at the faces of the parents when they get called for a parent-teacher meeting. If the child has learning problems or any kind of issues in school, you can be sure that that is not going to be a good parent-teacher meeting. But if this kind of a framework is developed, it's implemented, where right from the administrator to the person like the bus driver or the ancillary staff is made aware of the value of the child irrespective of his learning capacity, I think we have created an ideal world. And that, I think, is what we need to really aim for. When we were children, when academics was not driven into us, and we did all of this art and music and drama and all of that, I enjoyed going to school. But today, if you ask a child, after 1.5 years of sitting at home, are you ready to go back to school? Many children say no. Because the whole experience of going to school has become so stressful. It's always academic oriented that they are not really enjoying. In fact, I have my cousin's child just next door to me. I keep asking her, do you want to go to school? She said, no, I want to play badminton. I want to listen to my music. And yet I will learn. Of course, I'm learning through the video lessons. So I think children are really telling us that the way we run our classes is not, you know, what it should be. So I think NEP is a great shift in the direction, and a huge institution with such a strong foundation of wanting to do the right thing. The Shri Satya Sai Vidya Institute, Vahini Institution, and the dedicated team of professionals coming from different professional expertise. I mean, I'm amazed at what can be done with technology and how much work has gone into. Like Professor said, even I think the universities wouldn't have developed a framework like this. And it's all just done by volunteers. So I know I will play a very small role when it comes to what can a child with autism or a special needs child be taught in a school. But I feel if I can contribute a little bit to this entire framework, I think it is well served. So I will definitely try to do my bit, because this is really exciting. And I'm so glad that there is a digital means of putting the framework, making sure we have the content, taking the good lessons, but there's also a way to implement it. There is an SOP. There is a way, you know, there are taking steps when we're training different people, we're training the teachers, we're training everybody involved in that. I think that is going to be 100%, you know, sure of success. And I really hope that I can be a, you know, part to this whole thing. And I'm so grateful, and I feel fortunate that I made this connect with Karuna ma'am, and we're able to talk about some of these things. And I really hope to work together with this team. Thank you. Thank you so much. And I truly appreciate all the work. I'm glad that as a policy, national education policy has come, and a team like SSV is already thinking of the implementation and to such great detail. And I'm very glad that our children with special needs stand a chance in the near future. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am, for that wonderful talk and reinstating our belief and conviction. I now request Brother Saurabh Saxena and Sri Vidya to please come on and say a few words. Thank you.
Thank you, sirs, and thank you, ma'am. I just wanted to add one point. Under the Inclusive Education Project, we would include all the stakeholders in the orbit of a child with special needs. And that would include teachers, parents, shadows, school management and leadership, admin staff, transporters, canteen staff, and much, much more. And we are working on a very, very comprehensive training program, keeping in mind all the stakeholders. And we are not only providing the content, we are also going to provide how to use the content.
Yeah.
Because we cannot reach everywhere, even though how we wish that we could do that, you know, with more volunteers spread all over the country, but we would also provide the content on how to use the content. And if we have to sum up the whole model, what we are now working on, the whole model can be summed up in only two words, and those two words would be child first. And yeah, we are delighted that we can bank on the support of luminaries like Sridhar sir, Basav Raju sir, and Jashi ma'am. Very, very grateful. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Sir, we are feeling really blessed that you have come forward to guide us. That is such a blessing for us. We will just take this blessing. We will just grab this opportunity, sir. I'll be in touch with you and we will work out on how we can discuss and understand this further. And we would really be very, very happy, and it will be a big blessing for us to contribute for a national cause beyond providing content and teaching material. We would really like to understand this in detail from you, take your guidance, and our team of professional volunteers will always be ready to pitch in and do their bit, sir. With the support that we get from our director and the Central Trust, I think we can. So I will discuss with you further, sir, with Karuna ma'am also on the call. We can get on a call, discuss this, and see how we can get into this further, sir. I will now request Suhasini ma'am to propose the vote of thanks for all our dignitaries and participants. Thank you, everybody.
Saira, my most loving pranams at the divine lotus feet of my very dear Swami. And it's my pleasure and a privilege for me to be here, sir, to be proposing this vote of thanks to luminaries like Professor Sridhar, Brother Basavaraju, and Sister Jayashree. There has so much has been said about how you have proposed to take the whole thing forward and how appreciative you have been about Shri Satya Sai Vidya Vahini. So on behalf of the entire team of Satya Sai Vidya Vahini, we are grateful to you, sir, for being here and appreciating the efforts and all that you mentioned, the 3 points that where you have very clearly laid out as to how we can move forward and how the whole effort, expertise, experience. So there are 3 E's and 2 D's, sir, that you brought out to make this a national gift. As a very fruitful contribution from our end. And the points, the details have been taken, sir. I'm sure we will be able to go forward. Basavaraju, sir, we take forward to set a standard wherein so long we've been only working in smaller groups and there was no set standard for the entire nation as a whole, which Sri Satya Sai Vidya Vahini IE is proposing to take up. So very soon we'll be able to enter into details, of course, with the support and guidance that both Sridhar sir and you have extended so generously, sir. Thank you. And Madam Jayashree, you have been an example, you set an example for us as to how to engage with these children and make the whole system inclusive, wherein the entire society is able to accept not only the bus stands or roads or a part of it. And I thank all the volunteers who are here today to take forward all the proposals that have been given and make the learning teaching process more in-depth, more standardized, and at the same time, a huge gift, a huge representation of who all of us stand for. We represent our Bhagwan and we offer every bit of it is our offering to him. So it should be a befitting offering and I'm sure he will make it do it. So with that, I bring this whole session to a closure with my 3 prayers for the well-being of the whole world and the Shanti Mantra. Samasta loka sukhino bhavantu, samasta loka sukhino bhavantu, samasta loka sukhino bhavantu. Om shanti shanti shanti. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Jayashree. Thank you, Basiraj, sir.
Thank you so much. Sir, thank you, ma'am. Good night. Thank you and good night. We will be in touch.
Thank you very much.
Namaste. Thank you.
Bye, Basiraj, sir. See you.
Thank you. Bye, ma'am.